Okay, so let's just do some basic Wronskian practice stuff. So let's try this example. Say we're just asked to compute the Wronskian, and we'll give you a couple of these, just for fun. All right, so compute the Wronskian. Say we have this and this. This is pretty straightforward. All right, yikes, like that. So we're gonna compute the Wronskian now. As I do this, I remember that the Wronskian is defined as, and I like to try to remember it in its determinant formula because it's just a little bit easier, like that. That way I can just do the cross multiplication and just go from there, the determining thing. So y1 prime is e to the x, y2 prime is negative e to the negative x. So whenever I plug these in, choo, 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 and choo. So multiply minus multiply, and I end up with this minus this. Now, because I can math, I know that that's minus 1, minus 1, minus 2. Yay! The Wronskian is non-zero, which is good. It means that those constants will exist, so this is all going to work out. It's going to be beautiful. All right? So I'm going to give you a couple more and you can try them out. All right, so let's say we've got, again, compute the Wronskian for y1 is equal to cosine omega x and y2 is equal to sine of omega x. So actually, before we do this, let me do this right quick. The question is, why do we care that this is the Wronskian? That it's negative 2. Well, remember when we were doing our little coefficient thingies and we had like this is equal to something divided by the Wronskian? Well, if the Wronskian is equal to 0 at a certain point, then those coefficients don't exist. So this is actually a really, really big deal, and this would apply for other applications. The thing is, like, honestly, right now you're doing these little second order differential equations, you'd be like, well, I don't really care because this is stupid, and I could just do all this by hand anyway, and I didn't really need to compute the Wronskian. Well, the thing that's really cool about them is all this theory that you're learning actually works for, like, nth order differential equations. So if you, for some reason, are able to compute a Wronskian, and there's a bunch of different strategies and methods for doing that, basically the idea is you kind of compute the Wronskian first. And if it's non-zero, then you can actually worry about solving the problem. So if you go through all this trouble, you get a Wronskian, and the Wronskian is zero, then you know that you're going to be in really bad shape and that your solution is not going to be defined, or that if it's only zero at certain points, then you know that you're not going to find a solution at that point. So that's really why we care, is we're prepping for having to do gigantic differential equations in like some future life. So anyway, pause the video, take a look at this, see if you can define the Wronskian. And we'll pretend that happened. So y1 prime is minus omega cosine omega x, and y2 prime is omega cosine omega x. Oh, sorry, sine. Math is hard. Math isn't hard. Writing is hard. Okay, so I've got my y1, y1 prime, and then my y2, y2 prime. And I'm going to do my little shapoosh, shapoosh. So I've got omega cosine squared omega x minus a negative omega sine squared omega x. Pull out the omega. And clearly, I've got sine squared plus cosine squared, which is equal to 1. Which is equal to omega. So this is great. So as long as omega is non-zero, we have a solution. And honestly, if omega was zero, then this would be really boring because it would be cosine of zero is one and sine of zero is zero, so you wouldn't really have anything of value anyway. So as long as omega is non-zero, then we know that we have a solution. And again, it doesn't feel like we're doing a lot because these are these little dinky 2D problems, but the idea is you're learning stuff, so eventually when you look at these gigantic problems, your professor can be like, you've already seen this, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so last one of these, and then we'll try some other ones. Go ahead and give this a shot. So pretending that's happened, 2x, y2 prime, is negative 2x to the negative 3. So x squared 2x, 1 over x squared negative 2 over x cubed, determinant, negative 2 over x minus 2 over x is negative 4 over x. So this is important. This means that there's not going to be a solution when x is equal to 0. So if we have this huge problem and we're trying to solve it numerically, we have to make sure that our program avoided the holes, the thingies where the denominator is 0. Okay, so hopefully you're getting kind of convinced why I would care. But maybe you're like, I don't care because I'm never doing any more DiffyQ. Yeah, you say that, and then you end up recording videos on DiffyQ, thinking you probably should have paid more attention whenever you learned it the first time. So let's say we want to do kind of a different problem where you find the Wronskian of a specific function. Y double prime minus 2xy prime plus alpha times alpha plus 1y equals 0. Okay, so and I'm going to give you the initial condition for the Wronskian of being 1. Okay, now remember whenever we did this, we had something that looked like this, e to the negative px. But remember that we had it in standard form. So your first step is going to be write this in standard form. So see if you can write it in standard form, do the integration, and solve this problem. We'll assume that happens. So I'm going to rewrite in standard form. So if I rewrite in standard form, y double prime minus 2x, I'll say plus and negative 2x over 1 minus x squared, y prime plus alpha, alpha plus 1 minus x squared y, like that. So my Wronskian is going to be equal to 1, because that's my initial Wronskian, e to the negative minus 2x over 1 minus x squared dx. Now notice I don't even care what the stupid q term is, that alpha thing, because it just hasn't come up. Now you might be able to go ahead and look at that and go nuts and do the integration. If not, you can do integration substitution. So I've got du here, and I've got 1 over u, e to the negative 1 over u du, which is e to the negative natural log of u, which is e to the natural log of u to the negative 1, which is u to the negative 1, which is 1 over x, that thingy, like that. Okay, so again, finding the Wronskian, this tells you that for x is equal to 1 and negative 1, there's no solution. So you really want to be able to keep an eye out for it. Again, that's kind of why we're looking at the Wronskian, is it helps us define where those solutions are. Okay, there's one more fun thing we can do with Wronskians, and that's if you have a solution, if you can compute the Wronskian, then you can find the other solution. So let's say find the second solution that solves this guy, x squared minus 4y double prime plus 4xy prime plus 2y equals 0, assuming that you have one solution, which is y1 is equal to 1 over x minus 2, like that. Okay, so knock yourself out. See if you can figure out how to do this. Go review some of the other videos maybe and see. Otherwise, we'll take it from here. Basically, you've got this kind of thingy where we got to get it in standard form first, like that. So come here, like that. Okay, so I know that u prime is equal to some initial Wronskian. Now it didn't give it to me, but I can just leave it on there, e to the negative p of x dx divided by y1 squared. All right, so I'm going to focus on this little integration-y part here first. Actually, I'm just going to focus on this little integration-y part here. So integral of negative 4x over x squared minus 4 dx. Again, I can let, if you can do this by hand, or I mean not by hand, but if you can do this without whatevering, then do it. If you have to whatever, then that's what we're doing here. Let u equal that, and so du is equal to 2x dx. So I can take that 4 apart, make it a 2 and a 2. And then I've got 2x dx like that. So I've got negative 2, 1 over u, du, negative 2, natural log of u, natural log of u to the negative 2, natural log of, I'll just leave it there for the moment. Okay, so, oh, that's what I was going to do. Natural log of x squared minus 4 to the negative 2. Okay, so I've got that u prime is equal to this thingy, e to the, this thingy, over y1 squared. I forgot what y1, oh, y1 squared is this thingy. And that was just given. That's a negative 2. And then this thingy all comes down, so I have this over this. Over this. This is all kinds of pretty, now this is just algebra. Algebra is the easy part. I'm going to write a whole bunch of these out, so I've got this. X squared minus 4 is actually x plus 2, x minus 2 squared. I meant to do that in a different color, so it looked a little different. This right here is x plus 2, x minus 2. Okay, so I'm going to put that on the bottom and put the other thing on the top. So x plus 2 squared, oops, x minus 2 squared, and then there's an x minus 2 squared on the top. Those go away, and I end up with this x plus 2 squared. Now, I can integrate both sides. Integrate, well, hold on, let me make it pretty and then I'll integrate. So let's call it du is equal to omega naught 1 over x plus 2 quantity squared dx, and I'll integrate. So I've got that u is equal to that, and then if I just write it like x plus 2 to the negative 2, then that's negative 1 x plus 2 to the negative 1 plus some unknown constant. So u is going to be equal to whatever that initial Wronskian condition is over x plus 2 plus c, which means that, remember, we guessed that initially a long, long time ago that y2 is equal to u y1. So basically, if I knew the initial condition on the Wronskian and multiplied it by the original, then that would give me a nice little solution. So y2 would be given by that. And then plus some constant if that ended up being there. Now the constant isn't actually going to matter, I don't think, because I think it's just going to fold in, but we'll go ahead and leave it there. It will probably fold in later whenever, if we actually had more to do with this problem. But this is mostly just to kind of give you an idea of all the different kinds of things you can do with a Wronskian from kind of a fundamental level.